Over the course of its nearly 70-year history, Burger King has changed out its menu in a variety of ways. What was on the BK menu when you were born? Here's a look at how the Burger King menu has evolved since the 1950s. In 1953, Burger King was launched in Jacksonville, Florida. At the time, the restaurant was called Instaburger King, a name that the founders derived from a special kind of grilling machine, the Instabroiler. The Instabroiler was a futuristic piece of kitchen tech that cooked burger patties via radiant heat while toasting the burger buns simultaneously. The founders claimed that the appliance could cook 400 burgers per hour and that it ensured each burger was cooked uniformly, while retaining the meat's juices and preventing patty shrinkage. The menu, though, at that time, did not include the Whopper. It would be a few years until that appeared on the Instaburger King menu. Instead, diners found 18-cent burgers alongside milkshakes, french fries, and fruit pies. The Instaburger King Whopper appeared on the menu in 1957. Compared to the original 18-cent burger, the Whopper featured a larger patty and was topped with a special sauce, cheese, lettuce, tomato, and pickles. The larger burger came with a larger price tag, too, a whopping 37 cents. At the time, the Instaburger King restaurants still used the Instabroiler for cooking up its burger patties, but that would change when two franchise owners bought out the entire Instaburger King company in 1959 and switched all locations over to a gas grill contraption of their own creation, which they called a flame broiler. What exactly was it? Essentially, it was a broiler with a flame grill inside. You load patties onto a tray, insert them into the broiler, and then the flame grill does all the cooking. In addition to this major change, the new owners of the company would change up the BK name, dropping the Insta from the beginning just as easily as they dropped the Insta broiler from their kitchens. For the next two decades, the Burger King menu would remain much the same, with the Whopper taking center stage.
Yes, sir, may I help you?
Well, I'll have a Whopper, some fries, and a strawberry shake.
As other fast food chains began to expand their menus in the late 1970s and early 1980s, Burger King realized it would need to do much the same if it wanted to remain relevant against competitors such as McDonald's and Wendy's. So, new menu items were added, mostly thanks to new executives. At the time, Burger King was owned by Pillsbury, and the company brought in a previous McDonald's executive to both crack down on wayward franchisees and bring Burger King into a new age, a task that included several new menu items as well as international expansion. In order to appeal to an older demographic, Burger King introduced an array of new sandwiches to go alongside its burgers, including a fish sandwich, chicken sandwich, ham and cheese sandwich, and steak sandwich. The effort boosted restaurant traffic by 15%. Then, in response to McDonald's offering breakfast, Burger King began breakfast testing as well, though it would be a few years before the chain would stumble upon a winning breakfast formula. Burger King's breakfast success finally happened in 1983 when the Croissan'wich made its appearance. Still popular today, the Croissan'wich is and was exactly what it sounds like, a breakfast sandwich that uses a croissant as a bun. The Croissan'wich comes in several varieties, including sausage, bacon, and ham options, all with egg and cheese. But the breakfast success didn't end there. In 1985, Burger King introduced its French toast sticks, proving that Americans were interested in a French-inspired fast food breakfast. One big success for BK in the mid-1980s, chicken tenders. Introduced in 1986, chicken tenders were an immediate hit at Burger King locations, so much so that restaurants couldn't keep up with demand and the restaurant had to cancel a $30 million ad campaign introducing the menu item. In 1987, Burger King turned its attention to a new competitor, White Castle. Where Burger King had always gone big before, it now needed to go small in an effort to compete against a growing fast food giant. So it introduced burger bundles, sliders that came in quantities of six and were topped with mustard, ketchup, and pickles.
The tasty mini cheeseburgers, only at Burger King.
But while the burger bundles were popular with kids, and Burger King even introduced a chicken variant, there was a problem. The smaller-sized slider patties didn't work well in the automated flame broiler, and so Burger King soon canceled the burger bundles, making it one of the biggest flops in Burger King history. However, Burger King would go on to reintroduce the same concept as Burger Buddies, which were two small sliders connected together that you could tear apart. While the Burger Buddies were also discontinued, Burger King would revisit the slider concept time and time again. For the early 90s, Burger King made an attempt to slim down when it introduced its very first broiled, non-breaded chicken sandwich in 1990, the BK Broiler. Served on an oat bran roll, the menu addition was a stark contrast to a lot of the chicken products that were available from other fast food chains. As such, it was an immediate hit, selling at a rate of 1 million BK broilers per day just a month after the sandwich's launch, compared to Burger King's rate of selling 2 million Whoppers per day at the same time. However, the success would not last forever. By 1992, sales for the BK broiler would be slashed in half, with 500,000 chicken sandwiches being sold per day, while Whopper sales remained consistent. But the 1990s weren't aren't only about healthy options for Burger King. In 1997, Burger King introduced the Big King with two burger patties, two slices of cheese, lettuce, onions, pickles, and King sauce. The Big King was immediately advertised as a competitor to the Big Mac, with ads noting,
"It's like a Big Mac, except it's bigger and tastes better."
In 2002, Burger King announced the largest new product and new menu launch in the brand's history, all thanks to the 99-cent BK Value Menu. When introduced, the Value Menu included 11 different items, all of which cost 99 cents. However, the Value Menu wasn't just a compilation of various items already on the regular Burger King menu. It also included 6 new menu items that had never before appeared in Burger King dining rooms or drive-thrus. New items included a grilled sourdough burger, 2 kinds of tacos, beef chili, and baked potatoes, alongside already established Burger King favorites such as milkshakes, onion rings, french fries, and chicken tenders. Much like in the previous decade, in the early 2000s, Burger King decided to go healthy with the introduction of a new low-fat baguette-style chicken sandwich, as well as a low-carb burger. The former was created with baguettes baked fresh in each restaurant. Additionally, the baguette-style chicken sandwich only contained 5 grams of fat and was created in response to McDonald's and Wendy's having success with their low-calorie menu options, like full-size salads. The low-carb burger wasn't quite groundbreaking, however. It was simply a regular Whopper with the bun removed, and all of the ingredients served stacked in a plastic tray with a plastic knife and fork. The early 2000s were a busy time in terms of Burger King menu changes overall, though, with other additions to the menu including a new tender crisp sandwich and an Angus burger. In the mid-2000s, Burger King became a bit more creative with its new menu items, for better or for worse. It introduced an Angus Shroom and Swiss steak burger, as well as an Italian chicken sandwich. The former was simply a regular burger with the addition of Swiss cheese and sautéed mushrooms, while the latter was the restaurant's normal chicken sandwich topped with tomato sauce and mozzarella cheese. In 2005, Burger King also introduced a new breakfast sandwich, the Enormous Omelette Sandwich, which was truly enormous. The Mammoth Egg Sandwich featured 2 eggs, 3 strips of bacon, an oblong sausage patty, and 2 slices of American cheese. Unfortunately, the hefty sandwich also came with a lot of calories, 730 compared to a Whopper's 700. But according to Burger King, surveys were showing that consumers wanted bigger sandwiches. In the late 2000s, Burger King decided to return to a popular favorite menu item, the Burger Bundles and Burger Buddies. The newly named Burger Shots were simply rehashes of the previous Burger King sliders from the 1980s. You could order the Burger Shots as a meal for 2 sliders with french fries and a soft drink, or in a 6-pack. The 6-pack, similar to the Burger Buddies, featured 1 large connected patty that you had to tear apart, along with the buns. The Burger Shots were topped with ketchup and a pickle, and you could add cheese for a fee. In 2010, Burger King once again turned to one of its competitors for inspiration, which resulted in the birth of Burger King Ribs, an interestingly successful alternative to McDonald's McRib sandwich. The offering was a serving of 8 St. Louis-style pork spare ribs, and somewhat surprisingly, consumers loved them a lot. Burger King sold 10 million ribs and then ran low a week before the limited-time offer was intended to end, both on the ribs and on their special packaging. By the time 2013 rolled around, it was time for Burger King's health push for the decade. This time, the brand decided to offer a turkey burger and something it called Satis Fries. As for the fries, well, they didn't quite satisfy, and franchisees would later dump them from their menus on an individual basis. The more expensive Satis Fries were coated with a different batter than the regular BK fries, which the brand said made it harder for the fries to soak up oil while frying. Still, a small serving of the fries came with 270 calories. The turkey burger was pitched as an alternative to both the Whopper and a market saturated by chicken sandwiches by the mid-2010s. Burger King, at the time, was the largest fast food chain to offer a turkey burger, though it wasn't the first. That was Carl's Jr. and Hardee's, a few years earlier. While Burger King had initially said that the new menu item had potential as a permanent menu fixture, sales weren't strong enough to make it happen. More flops were in Burger King's future later on in the decade. The Whopperito was a huge failure, with a Newsweek article loudly proclaiming, "Burger King's new Whopperito is as disgusting as it looks." The Burger Meats burrito was pretty simple. Beef, lettuce, tomato, onion, and pickle, all together in a tortilla along with a cheese sauce. Burger King introduced the item as its first Tex-Mex option, seeing as the Tex-Mex fast food category was one of the fastest growing in the biz. Then there were the Mac and Cheetos, which were essentially Cheetos filled with macaroni and cheese. Newsweek called the product, quote, gross. Burger King also came out with hot dogs in 2016. Their hot dogs were successful at first, with 80 to 120 hot dogs selling per store per day. However, it seems like after consumers overcame the novelty aspect of the dogs, they decided they just weren't that good, and the hot dogs were discontinued. Over the last several years, Burger King has had some contrastingly successful menu changes. In 2018, the chain released its own spicy chicken sandwich, which received high marks. Topped with iceberg lettuce, mayonnaise, and a tomato, and heavily breaded, the BK Spicy Chicken Sandwich is strongly spicy and comes in a junior version as well. A year later, in 2019, Burger King went plant-based with its Impossible Whopper. The sandwiches were a huge success, leading to the chain's strongest growth in years. Unfortunately, Burger King's Impossible Whopper did have some controversy surrounding it, and even caused a lawsuit, because despite some misleading advertising, the sandwich is not vegan. Still, that didn't stop Burger King from going on to release a plant-based breakfast sandwich later in the year. Also in 2019, Burger King had a hit on its hands with its Bacon Cheesy Tots. This menu item is exactly what you think. Tots filled with bacon and cheese and fried. They're also served with a side of ranch dressing. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Mashed videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.